had retrieved the ring, handing it against the Jaggedmore. Seems too good to be true, right? Well, that's because it is. And here's why. To start with a big one, the arrow isn't real. It's actually a piece of elastic that looks like an arrow when pulled taut. But as soon as it's released, it's pulled inside the bow, hiding it away. The moment that occurs, a remote activated mechanism swings a knife previously hidden inside the tray holding the apple, too fast to easily see. That knife is on a hinge and slices straight through the apple, making it look like an arrow has passed through. Then, from a concealed slit in the target board, a spring-loaded arrow is released, moving outward, giving the impression that an arrow has just landed on the board. So, how does the ring end up on the target board arrow? Well, almost immediately after placing it inside the apple, Aaron pushes the ring out the other side using the core, sneakily taking it back into his hand. When he unveils the target, he subtly secures the ring onto the concealed arrow, ready for it to pop up later. With the level of creativity that goes into the trick, the explanation is arguably just as interesting as the trick itself. Do you agree? Let me know in the comments down below. Close shave. While some tricks rely on big explosive spectacles, others keep audiences on their seat by creating a real sense of fear for the magician's body. That's exactly the case with the swallowing razors trick pioneered by Japanese magician Tanba. His nail-biting performances involves first swallowing several razor blades, which he demonstrates are real by getting a volunteer to cut paper with one on stage beforehand. After swallowing the first batch, he shows the audience his tongue to prove they've gone down the hatch. Before grabbing a handful of about a dozen more, the audience's horror, he swallows all of those too, and washes them down with a shot of green absinthe. Finally, he pops a load of red string into his mouth, moves it around inside, and then delivers the impossible. Given the string and out it comes, threaded through over a dozen razor blades, all in perfectly spaced intervals. It's an incredible trick. Did he really swallow all those blades and tie them to the string instead? Unfortunately, depending on how squeamish you are, the answer is no. The first few razor blades Tanba appears to swallow are indeed real, though likely wanted to stop the trick being too dangerous. When his volunteer cuts a piece of paper to demonstrate the blade's sharpness, he pulls the paper tight so even a blunted blade slices through easily. Then, as the first few blades are placed in his mouth, he makes a big show of swallowing them, but actually puts them into his cheeks. As for the huge handful of blades later, he subtly moves them into his other cheek. These new blades aren't sharp at all. They're actually gimmick blades designed for the purpose and are completely safe. When he takes a sip of bright green apple, which is quite a gross water with blue coloring, he sneakily strips out the real blade. Thanks to the coloration of the blade and the semi-opacity of the glass, only the most perceptive audience member would be able to spot the blades now at the bottom. When Tanba puts the string in his mouth, he actually stuffs it into his upper lip. The string the audience sees threaded through the blades has actually been tied to them the whole time. He just hid it from sight behind his fingers when he put the fake blades into his mouth. True with masterful deception. Well, that's what I call a sharp trick. Impale. Another trick that strikes worry into the hearts of the audience is the impale illusion. This trick involves an assistant seemingly defying the laws of physics by being balanced upon the point of a sword. Often the effect is emphasized by the magician spinning their assistant around, which somehow doesn't screw the assistant with a shish kebab. That is, until all of a sudden, the assistant jumps downward, and the blade of the sword bursts out from their belly. The assistant appears dead, and the magician gives them another spin to prove the sword's gone straight through. Then, the magician lifts their assistant off of the blade, and brings it back alive, trying to drag them out of a gaping hole in their face. Well, the secret fist trick. Now, the magician is concealed under a fluffy top. When the time's right, the commercial contract is doing its case and here it's a back. Meanwhile, in the front of the music, the loaded telescopic hole extends out unactivated, making it look like the sword has penetrated straight. It's time to move the season free. It's the same process in reverse, with the assistant pressing the spring loaded to take back. Extreme variations of the huge
Don't steal my kill. Oh my fucking god. Of course you steal my kill. So? No, it means don't steal the kill when someone's already shot him. No, I'm not coming to you, so don't fucking mark.
This makes it look like the drill has passed through the performer and then through the cover. As a final spectacle, the performer is lifted in the air by the drill, spun around before being lowered and covered again. After the covering is removed, the drill has miraculously retracted from their body, or in other words, the other assistants sneakily carried it away under a cloth while the audience was distracted in amazement. From regurgitation. David Blaine, the world-famous illusionist and endurance artist, is no stranger to an outlandish piece of performance. One of Blaine's strangest tricks sees him swallowing a frog before regurgitating it moments later, free of harm. Usually, this is accompanied by something known as water spouting, where Blaine momentarily turns himself into a decorative water fountain by squirting a huge amount of water out of his throat. Certainly not a spectacle.
Don't steal this kill.
That's far from the case. The secret is, it's real. Turns out, after years of training, David Blaine has become a master of regurgitation. By learning to precisely control the muscles in his upper abdomen, and by drinking a huge amount of water beforehand, he can create substantial upward pressure in his lower esophagus. This, coupled with the abilities to disable his gag reflex and willfully open the upper esophageal sphincter, allows Blaine to hold the frog midway down his esophagus. This prevents him falling all the way into his stomach. Then, using what is essentially highly controlled vomiting, Blaine regurgitates the frog alongside a huge amount of water. You may be asking, why would someone do such a thing? The only answer is, it's all for the sake of... drill to the head. Over the past few years, various performers have taken to performing one scary looking trick that appears to use power tools in a totally manner. This trick involves pressing a running drill against their head for an uncomfortably long time, somehow avoiding damaging themselves. The reason they don't sustain damage is simple. The performers use flat drill bits that are completely blunt, meaning they can't grip or tear the skin. While the drills are steady, your arms and use intense facial expressions to create a big show of pressing hard against their temples. But despite how it looks, they really only press very lightly, meaning there is absolutely no risk of hurting themselves.
At Officeworks, we know some people like to shop in the morning, cock-a-doodle-doo, and others at night. Ooh, ooh. That's why we open early and close late. Nothing like getting two birds with one stone.
Some take it a step further by sticking a drill up their nose or down their throat, which
well,
the rest of
the
act is actually
not do their jobs.
The same principles
hey,
as sword
can you finish this?
To align their
I don't really host parties. I'm more of an
however, while the
esteemed
drill
guest of honor type of guy.
More dangerous part of the
well, they didn't forget the party poppers. These things are the worst, but they're very effective at getting a party
yes.
started.
Seems a
why don't you guys set them off while I run these numbers again? Because that cannot be right.
Either way, it shouldn't need to be said, but even if you think the drill is a little blunt, don't try this one at home. Chainsaw Madness. While most tricks I've covered so far could be performed by anyone with a good bit of cash to invest in the materials, this next one is really complicated. Not because it breaks the balls of physics or anything, but because it requires a very unique type of assistant. Pioneered by illusionist Kevin James, this trick abruptly begins with a nutty scientist chainsawing his white-coated assistant in half while he's pulling the table on stage. All in plain sight, with no apparent concealment, the scientist character then props up his assistant's severed torso and spins it around while it moves its hands, proving that it's very much alive. Then, somehow, the legs begin to move too, despite being separated. With the effect, the torso then lifts itself up and The scientist runs his hand underneath, proving its lower body is truly detached, not just hidden somewhere. Then the torso is placed onto a lower platform while the legs walk themselves off stage. Another assistant then reappears carrying the legs back over and places them behind the torso. Then the legs and torso are wheeled off stage while the scientist ominously presents a staple gun to the audience. The legs and torso come back on again, and before the audience can catch a breath, the mad scientist staples the leg and torso together, which then stand up and dance. Pretty crazy stuff. And with a neatly crazy explanation, this trick is made possible due to the fact that the lower free torso is taken on by someone who genuinely has no lower body. Turning an unfortunate disfigurement into a source of amazement, the torso assistant is wheeled on, perched atop the legs, and those legs belong to a full-sized person whose upper body is hidden away inside the table. This explains how the legs and upper body are able to move separately after the dummy chainsaw passes between them. When the legs walk themselves off stage, an assistant reappears carrying a pair of fake legs and identical trousers to prop up behind the torso. Then, when the legs and torso are temporarily wheeled off, they're swapped for another surgical mask wearing assistant of vaguely similar appearance in an identical outfit. And when the switch surgical mask assistant positions themselves in a way that looks like they're still cut in half, or switching positions to lie on the back, ready for the Via Simply celebration dance. After all that crazy magic, I think we can all take a very well-earned bow. Which of these trick reveals will you find the most? Do you know any magician secrets of your own? Let me know in those comments down below. Thanks for watching.
You magician yet?
Working on it.
My safe word is kind of...
Hey, you just locked the door on me. Don't take another step. You throw like a girl. There's a 9mm at your face. What are you gonna do?
No. I was just following a kid that I killed, so he followed me to his a teammate. Fucking worked, that's for sure. By the way, the dance spot was right where I am. Right here. Okay, maybe I need help. Yes.
And we currently have 100 players. What's interesting to note is look how long the line is, right? It goes all the way down there. And Fortnite added this guy. So, is this gonna be in a straight line? That's pretty straight to me, honestly. That should do it. What?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, wait. Let me line it up. Do you see that? It's pretty straight. Pretty straight, and ready. Oh, lining it up? That's perfect. That's a complete straight line. This is it. I'll tell you. That is pretty dang satisfying.
Okay.
Hey everyone, it's AK30 here. I am Darth Vader, and that's currently 100 mm-hmm. players. We're going to be doing the new animation, which you can throw. Like that. Okay, I thought it would go way further. Like this. And it comes back to you, and like this. We're going to do a duel. Last one to survive win. That almost got him. Hey everyone, it is Nick830 here, and today we're going to be reacting to the new update. I didn't expect there to be this much. And apparently, okay, so I did see that Logjam changes themes every single game. And right now, we actually have a boat. This reminds me of Pirate Season. It looks almost like Tilted. You guys remember the Tilted that was the area you couldn't build? Another new game, right, on web swinging. And now it's like the Colossal Coliseum, right? We have all those areas. Boom. Oh, because the reality tree. It's infecting all the areas. That's going right up in here. What the heck? I've never seen the map that colorful before. I want to go see right now what the lightsaber mythic is looking like, though, guys. What is that noise? Oh, it's down. Oh! Oh, it's like the Iron Man season. You know how the ships fly in? Is this where Darth Vader is? Why is it? It is Darth Vader! Oh, crap.
Camp in bushes. Stay in the bushes. Good, good. Spray. I'm really, 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 really